outside. You would think I'm outside.
Now we have activated recording as well. And now just a few words about you, since you are with us for the first time.
Okay.
But I assume not for the last one. I have to tell you the story of Willow Barnowski. I don't know if you know Willow Barnowski. He was also, she was also an exchange fellow, and she continues cooperation with IATEFL Poland. So she keeps in touch with us. Hello, everybody.
Hi. Yes. Thanks. From Serbia. Right on. Mahalo.
I'm from
Honolulu. So mahalo and aloha and things like that they come out naturally. My name is Beth Barry, and I was born and raised in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, but I left there and I've lived around the world, and I've been teaching in different places for like 30 years. So what I'm going to show you tonight are just some ideas for helping the students with discussion. I'm at a university now. I'm in Krakow at the pedagogical university here. And so I asked my students at the beginning of the school year, what were some things they wanted to talk about? And I got a list from them, and it was an anonymous list because I wanted to make sure the time I spent with them was going to be useful and engaging. And I think some of my students had a little bit of a culture shock having me as a teacher. Many of them have never had a native speaker American crazy lady from Hawaii teach them before, so you know, there was some culture shock going on. But the other thing is, many of them have, you know, they've had a lot of education online, and then we were in the classroom, and there was some hesitancy with sharing. And also you know, they just haven't had the time to develop relationships and friendships with their colleagues in school, like they would have if COVID would not have happened. So I've kind of felt that going on, and I was trying a lot of using my own energy to like get the students to come on, do some more, you know, let's get into this, you know. And it was, you know, I'm happy to use my energy, but at the same time, it's like, you know, you're a limited resource. You can't just keep throwing yourself in there like that much every single time and hope to survive the year. So I've had a lot of different experiences teaching with lots of different types of English learners. And what I'm showing you here right now in front of you, if you're looking, you're seeing these things that say my timeline. This is something I learned when I was in South Korea teaching from a colleague, because she also was experiencing at that point, like many of us did, teaching in South Korea and also Japan, that's where I've taught as well. The students had a hard time getting started because of just cultural issues with sharing and just being shy and embarrassed and not knowing exactly what was okay to say and not okay. So this timeline exercise gives people some freedom there. Also, there are a lot of very talented drawers out there, students who are artists. And so, this gives them an opportunity to express themselves in this way too. And so I would really highly recommend to people, if you are having issues or not, even if you're not, just to offer something like this where the students are drawing as a way to also do discussion, which however way you go with it, if it's just WHNH questions or to be or to do, you know, do questions, or if you have other things planned, this has really been a fun thing to do for me always. And so what you see in front of you right now are two students who have drawn their timelines. And the timeline starts from birth. And what they have to highlight or draw are five significant events in their life up until the present. And so they draw five significant events. And the students, the partners, have to figure out what those pictures mean. And so what you see, this student, for example, some things you might be able to look at and go right away, oh, I think it's this or I think it's that. But sometimes you have to give each other hints. And that's all part of the exercise, to discuss, to use your language ability, to partner with somebody to help you. If you have, I was gonna say pukas, that's Hawaiian for like, if you have gaps that you don't have the right word. So you see here, this student has their timeline, this student has theirs, but they've swapped. They're not looking at their own, they're looking at their partners, okay? So WH&H questions are something that we use all the time for discussion. In this particular case, what I like to do is have students say, is this when, to start out. So they're looking at the different pictures and trying to figure things out. And then they maybe point to one and say, is this when you whatever? And they try to guess what it is. If they're correct, then there's embellishment. The job of the questioner is then to get more information, follow up, follow through, until they get all of these pictures identified and they understand what all of these mean to the person. And it gives them an opportunity to really learn more about each other in ways that they usually don't learn about each other. They oftentimes are asking questions like, you know, what's your favorite movie and where do you like to go after school and what's your favorite food and all of that. But this is giving them more insight into their history. And oftentimes it gives them an opportunity to, have some point in common that they would not have figured out or known before. So this is one example, and I have a few examples for you, and I actually have video from the classroom. So this is the timeline exercise. And then after this, I also have an exercise that has to do with music, okay? So I'm just gonna show a few more of these to you so you can see this. Hopefully this will work out all right. So that's that one. Here's another version. And so you can see how students, I'm gonna admit somebody, there we go. You can see how some students preferred to use their laptop or whatever their computer is. I would ask everybody right now, or the trauma-informed framework. Yeah, okay, yeah. I'm answering the questions here. Somebody just asked about, do you frame this somehow? And I say, yes. What I'd like to tell the students is please only write things, you know, draw pictures of things that you would feel comfortable talking about. And if you're not comfortable talking about it, then don't include it, okay? Oftentimes students write things to me, they want me to know, but they are afraid to tell others. And I give them that opportunity at the beginning of the school year. I always ask them 5 questions and things about them, please answer. And it's just between you and I. And if there's anything that you are wanting me to know, but maybe you don't want other people to know, this is the opportunity. And so I try to create that confidence with them that, you know, they can talk to me and we can share things and I will respect their privacy. So I'm going to just ask you if you want to try to guess what some of these pictures could mean. And maybe put it in the chat if you want to. What do you think the students are trying to say? Like, for example, here, what do you think this could be? Anybody? Be brave. What do you think the students might be saying there? Yay! All right, McLean Lear, is that how you say your name? I'm sorry if I'm saying it wrong. This is always one of my things. I always try to get the students' names right. But yeah, this was students saying this was a big moment for them because this was their first trip abroad and they went to Ireland. And half of me is Irish, so you know I always applaud that. Yay for them, you know, for that. And then other things, I'm seeing somebody here in the chat. Yes, that's okay, German tongue twister. All right, thank you for that. So then you see here, this was, if you look at this, a concert. I've always so amazed at how well students draw because I am the stick figure girl and that's like about all I can do. But I'm always amazed when the students, they start, putting a little time and energy into it and it comes out like this. I want to say this at this point. In order for the students to have the time to be able to draw and put the time in to think about what they want to draw and what they want to share, I gave this assignment to them for over the break. So I had a test before Christmas for all 8 of my classes. And so then when they finished the test, I gave them the opportunity to start working on this. And so that's what they did. And they started to get invested in it before the break. So they finished it over the break. And I was so pleased that everybody came back from the break with their pictures done. Everybody, you know, so I was like, all right, yay, this is working. They want to do this. Okay. And so of course I was also a grade. I gave them, you know, 10 points for coming to class with everything finished. Okay. I'm just looking at that some through the chat. There was something written. All right. So this is another version of it. And here you can see, this is the baby. Everybody started out with the baby, and then you have your five major points. And then now this is where they are now. This is the present. And like I said, we did this before New Year's. We did this at the end of the semester, more or less. And then they came back after New Year's. And I wanted to do that intentionally so that they would feel like they're stepping out into the new year, new you, new year, new you. And here's what you've accomplished already in your life. Look at these major events that you've already gone through, achieved for good or bad. And now here we are coming into the new year, and let's, you know, make it a good one. I added on to this lesson, because I have a 90-minute class, a bit of a lesson on wellness and health, because students, again, had asked me to do a little lesson on, or to talk about mental health. And so I found a resource that was conducive to the class and to what they're, you know, the environment of the class. And we did a mental health like addition to this that came through from the BBC, actually. So that's this one. Here's another one. And I loved how this student incorporated the lyrics from this song. And he wanted to share that with his partners as well. And so I didn't ask for this, but this was just something he wanted to add to it. So he did. And again, like he used plain piece of paper just with his pictures. He didn't do as much color and drawing as the other folks, but that's okay. Like I said, you know, I'm not looking for a Picasso. I'm just looking for you to give it your best effort. And again, you can maybe guess what are some events that they're talking about here. Here is, looks like somebody went to the hospital. Thanks, Jen. I just got a message from Jen. And this, I think you could maybe guess somebody passed away here, his dog. And then Tenerife, he went to Tenerife, and this was some kind of accident, okay? But to get the details and to have the other students get to know each other more, like I said, we used the question, is this when? And they had to flesh it out. It wasn't just, is this when your dog died? Yes. Why did he die? How did he die? What happened? You know, then you get more involved with it. It's not just a one-off, because I'm trying to get them to discuss as much as they can. And also to find words and things that they don't know. Some of them like were shocked when they're like, what's that thing called when you're a little kid and you're drawing pictures inside of it? And it's, you use crayons and things. I'm like, oh, coloring book. And they're like, yeah, yeah, that's what I'm like, words like that, that they have not had to use or you know, before. They've suddenly realized they don't know what it is. Like, you know, what is that? Because they haven't talked about this part of their life that much. All right. So that's that one. Here's another one. Okay. And the students, again, this one, this person has done a lot of coloring and made some really lifelike pictures. The details here, you know, very, very much you can figure it out. A lot of people traveled for the first time to like warm, sunny places, which was fun to talk about when it was cold. But here we go. See, this person's baby, they really got into drawing the baby versus like some of the other people that was kind of like not even there. So I wanted to show you the pictures and just give you an idea of how this went and then show you live what they were doing. So this is just the hard copy, okay? And now I'm going to show you the students in action. Okay, so here we go.
No, I can't stop.
Let me see if we can get a bigger. See, oh, no, I don't want to mail it to you. Oh, wait. No, let me get it over here again. Sorry.
Maybe you can stretch it if it doesn't want to get bigger. Just, you know.
So I can tell you right away because it's kind of
practical. Oh, give her a hint. Come on.
So this is as big as I can make it, I think. Sorry, guys.
No.
Let me put it in the middle. That might be more helpful. Mm-hmm, okay, mm-hmm. So what you're hearing, I want you to notice, like at the beginning, you know, I was just swooping in with my camera, kind of videotaping this. I didn't want to stifle anybody. So I was trying to be, you know, kind of stealth, not real good at that. But anyway, I was trying. And what I heard was the students, like, you know, they were trying to give up some of them. And my job then always is to facilitate, come on, try more. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. And I wanted you to hear that interaction, how these pictures generated that.
No, I can tell you right away because it's kind of
okay. Can you hear what she's saying? Oh, I'll just tell you because it's kind of get hard. And then I jump in and say, no,
come on.
So she gives her hint. It's about writing. It starts with writing.
Writing, okay.
Yes, I was writing. And I started writing. And I website, but I started because I was doing my own, website. So you can guess what it looks.
Okay, so I hope you heard that. So if, first of all, she's wanting to give up because they, oh, it's going to be too hard, you're not going to get it. And then I insist, no, keep trying. And so she, the partner's like, is it about writing? And then she gets involved in, yes, explaining it's about writing. And then lo and behold, her partner also did the same thing. Okay, so here she's saying that again. In the chat, some people said it wasn't clear, but I hope you are able to hear it okay. I've done this level with students at very lower levels, you know, maybe not at super beginner levels, but students definitely that can do things like ask for things, get directions and that type of thing. But it's definitely a way to try to push them up. And five is not necessarily, you know, what you need to do. I've done with three because the students' levels are lower and it takes more time for them to find words and they need to help each other with vocabulary and that type of thing. The idea is to build confidence. And I'm all about the whole person when it comes to teaching. So I don't want people, like somebody asked about, are you, you know, careful with what they say and, you know, give them safety measures, safety zones. For sure. The idea is for them to have an opportunity to share what they might not otherwise be able to share, but they want to share it, right? And to give them the time and space to do that. And this is one example, and I got a couple more I want to share for you to see, and maybe hopefully it will be, they will come out, they will be louder for you, or more, you'll be able to hear them better. Here's another one. Let me put it here. Okay.
Can you guess them all?
Okay, so you can hear him saying, why did I say that? So he's trying to get her into the realm of what he's, you know, drawing about or what it's all about. And so he's giving hints, which was great, because sometimes students, like the previous video where they kind of give up early and they just start to tell each other what it is. And it's way more interesting and fun if they are keep trying to work around, you know, and circumlocute is in, with words they're not sure of, so that they help each other like build vocabulary. And of course, you know, classroom community, which is for me, is super, super important.
Giving hints. Okay. Great. Did you get them all? Yes. Okay. I'm curious about the samurai. That looks like a samurai to me. Is it right? Am I right?
No, it's like it's a character from like a universe consisting of games, books, and just it symbolizes the period of time. I started reading those books and it lasted like for 1 year.
Yeah, that's basically my first job. It changed me a lot. These are major events. This looks like DNA. I was so mad.
Because I am much of an introvert, so I appreciated the time at home.
Oh, you liked it?
Yeah.
Good perspective.
Yeah.
All right, so that is another idea there that this student who was sharing. And again, some incredible drawing. Here is this one I wanted to share again because there was some connection here that was coming out that was really fun.
Oh, let me see that. Yes. Did you ever see that movie?
Yeah, I see.
And for me, what's really fun is I'm listening and hearing all the volume behind me and around me. So everybody is engaged. Everybody is on task. And the volume of the room, you know, would get more and more. So like for some people who are a little shyer, or, you know, a little bit more hesitant to talk, would have to maybe raise their voice a little bit more, because there was so much engagement going on. So, you know, that again, this can work with things like that, with people who just are a little shyer to talk, can help them.
Okay, keep going. Hover over. I think I see love there.
And this was the thing, I videotaped this knowing that we were gonna have this, and I usually don't tape my students very much. And I want to make sure that they just feel free to be doing their thing. So some of the time I was just like, okay, forget I'm here. And so sometimes some of them stopped talking when I came over. So, but for the most part, they were willing to let me share with them, you know, with you with this video.
Airplane. No.
And this was another really fun exchange because the students figured out something that they didn't know about each other while they were doing this.
Hi, bus.
Hi, bus. Came to school by bus. What is this? I'm seeing things upside down. Oh. I see somebody fell. Oh no!
In karate.
Fourth place. Oh, it's not her first, but.
Right, you never know. Okay.
Yeah.
It looks like you have a dog and a cat.
Yeah.
Wow. So is this the first pet you have?
Yeah, that's not. I still have two cats and one dog. Oh, I'm allergic to cats.
As I got older, I ended up stopping being allergic. Do you like, oh, it's UP. I saw the university friends.
Yeah, I meet my best friend
there. Oh, nice. So you've met, this is like, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You've met about 6 friends, I hope?
Yeah.
All right, good. Is there anybody in this class?
Yeah, and one of them is
Yay! Right on, and this is his story.
He also trains like martial arts.
is that how you guys got to be friends, or did you?
So through this activity, they found out that they both have done martial arts. They've both trained with martial arts.
No, actually, we didn't know about that until like now.
Okay.
That we are not going to fight.
Good. Please don't do that here.
Yeah, I love that. We're not going to fight. So yeah, and you know, the students I've been teaching here are lovely. They're amazing, and they want to be engaged and they want to try. So this was just an example of this one activity that I've done with the timelines. Again, I used this when as the question that would get people going. But of course, after that, you want to have them, or at least I'm wanting them to do a follow-up with more WH&H questions. This was something that I was asked to do as part of my assignment here, is try to get the students to be digging more when they have discussion and not just be superficial. And so that helped facilitate this exercise. The next thing I want to show you has to do with music. I said it on the write-up for this, that we used music too. And I was blown away when my students, when the response they gave me, when I said, okay, we're gonna share our favorite song. That's what we're gonna do. But you're not just going to tell me what your favorite song is. I want you to do a video or do a PowerPoint or do some kind of visual that is part of your explanation about what your favorite song is and why. And it has to be under 2 minutes. So you need to answer 5 questions, WH&H questions, when you give your presentation about your song, so that your classmates can hear questions and hear the answers to questions and write them down. So it's not passive listening. They have to be listening for the answers to questions. That was one way to do it. Another way to do this is to just have them in pairs share what they've done. But because they're so social media savvy and they're on TikTok and they're on YouTube and they're doing all these things, and they all have cell phones, I've tried to embrace the cell phone as a tool for the classroom and to make them put it away when we don't need it, but to welcome it when it can be helpful to us. And so in this case, with the videos and them coming to class prepared with their favorite song to share with their classmates, the quality of the work was unbelievable. And I thought, you know, I wanted them to be able to use, you know, the time and be in groups together, but we basically ended up sharing, and it was more presentational than it was just small group or pairs. But this kind of activity can very well just be for pairs. And so I'm going to show you one first. I'll show you this. This was what the student wrote as to what her favorite song was. And of course, this is a discussion class, right? So I wasn't going to jump in on them too much for grammar problems and other and that kind of thing, because that is somebody else's, you know, class, but I would and did correct, you know, small mistakes or not small, but mistakes that were gonna interfere with the discussion. And I tried to be, you know, helpful in that way, but I didn't wanna overcorrect anybody and stifle anybody. from the discussion part because I wasn't really there for the writing part. So anyway, this is what they came up with. The other thing that was really interesting to me is, you know, I'm obviously older, right? And these students are like 18, 19, 20 years old, and they're like coming up with the Def Leppard and all these songs that were Black Sabbath. I'm like, how do you guys even know this music? And I'm thinking, oh, it must be their parents telling them, right? So anyway, here's an example of a person. She put together this paragraph, and these were the questions she wanted people to be able to answer about her presentation. And she gave the YouTube link. And so as a class, we would watch this. Like I said, if you just want to do small groups or pairs, it's possible, especially since they all have their own cell phone. And then ask and answer these questions and go deeper about it. So this was a written, she handed this in to me. Some students I asked for handwritten work because they missed class or they were late or something like that. And they didn't get the chance to stand up in front of everybody. So they handed things in to me. But for the most part, everybody was able to do it live. And so this is an example of what one of the students came up with. I want to share this with you. And this was like the type of quality that they delivered was amazing. Let me just make it, no. I'm still learning all this stuff. Sorry, guys. So here we go. And feel free to jam so long. Especially if you're like getting sleepy. And then she goes.
What you have just listened to is my favorite song of all time, I think. As for my favorite song, I often change my mind, but I return to this one very often. Its title is September, and it was released in 1978 by the American band Earth, Wind and Fire. The song...
Now, that was, like, for me, amazing. 1978, okay? And... You know, so she's listening to this music. Of course, this is a really popular party song and song for weddings and that kind of thing. But when I heard this come on in class, I could not believe it.
Undeniable Groove focuses on a carefree living in the moment philosophy. Its lyrics focus on remembering the good times of the past. Written by Al McKay, Maurice White, and Ali Willis, September combines soul, R&B, jazz, and funk. The first time I heard the song was at some party at the friend's house where older songs were played. I couldn't help but dance, and I really think this song instantly puts you in a good mood. Plus, its simple lyrics make it effortless to sing along after a while. September has maintained an enduring pop media presence, including being used in the movies Soul Food and Night at the Museum. Moreover, popular singer Taylor Swift covered this song in 2018. A small fun fact is that the writing process took close to 4 months, with Willis and White drafting over 20 pages of ideas. Since this is an old song, I think at least some of you have already heard it, but for those who don't know it, I encourage you to give it a listen.
Okay. And so that was her rendition of this, and let me see now how to get this smaller again. Like this? Yeah, I think. Whoops. What happened? Okay. So anyway, she did this. And of course, they did it at home and brought it into class. Some students have their own YouTube channels, and they just did it on their own YouTube channel, and then they showed it in class. And of course, when they do it at home, when they do it on their own, with their own phone, and they have their video, they can record it, listen again, try again, and do it better. And for me, I was always trying to tell them slower is better when you're doing presentations, because then the listener gets a better chance to hear. So many of them try to rush. And I think some of that's nerves, of course, but when they're made to listen to themselves and go, okay, maybe she's right. Maybe I need to slow down a little bit because it is harder to hear. And in this way, there was a lot of really good quality videos and material that the students came up with. And they love sharing this. They couldn't wait to get up and share this. And I was a little bit nervous thinking, oh my gosh, it's okay. I'm pulling teeth here by trying to get them to, you know, get a video and do it in 2 minutes. And I had criteria because I had a marking sheet where I was listening to their vocabulary, their pronunciation, to try to help support them in that way. And then I gave that back to them as a feedback. But, you know, I felt bad that we didn't have more time because we had to get this done in a 90-minute session. And I could have done this for two classes easily and given them time to sit with each other after they shared and just gone over their material. One thing I forgot to mention with the timeline exercise and this and everything that I do with discussion is I rotate the students. I never just do a one-off because a lot of times the first time they see something, they're just getting warmed up and they're just starting to get comfortable. And so what I like to do is get them started and then maybe let it go for 10 minutes or so until I start to hear maybe things start to cool down a little bit. And then it's like, all right, everybody on the wall, stay seated. Everybody on this wall, stay seated. You folks in the middle, move. And then they rotate to different seats. Always, of course, checking to make sure people aren't sitting with their best friend all the time, you know, that kind of thing. And then the material they get more than one try going through the material and learning about each other and being comfortable and confident in the discussion. So it's usually three times that I let them rotate with anything like this. And by the third time, I've had some really joyful experiences with this, and I would hope that you all have the same, you know, and just enjoy what they bring in, you know. Like I said, I'm older, and when I'm hearing this kind of stuff, it just makes me giggle, you know. It brings a big smile on my face. Okay, one more thing here I'll show you that has to do with the presentations, like that students did with music, is some of them went into PowerPoint and did it, okay, like this student. And I did not ask them to do this. This was them thinking this is what they wanted to do. They made a PowerPoint presentation with the pictures of the person, you know, the group with information. And then they embedded the video and played it for the class. But they could only, you know, I was trying really hard to just keep it to 2 minutes because otherwise it would just be, we'd be going on for days. And some of them had a hard time with that. But for the most part, they were able to control it and do 2 minutes and then share, you know, their thoughts and feelings about it. This was just amazing to me that they put this much effort in and were this engaged. And like I said, I did not ask for all this, but they wanted to do it. And I saw the students last semester. I'd see them every other week. And so, you know, they had more time to do it. I wouldn't give this to somebody and ask them to get it done in a week. I would give them a couple weeks. But it seemed to me that they prioritized this over other things and they got it done. So because they wanted to share it with their classmates. And so that is another version of the music. I'm seeing some chats. I want to make sure that. Okay, great. Okay, I want to make sure. Okay. Yes, yes, yes. And of course, all of this, like the cultural awareness point, which brings me to the point of some of the students shared Polish songs and they, you know, it wasn't all in English. And they asked me that. It's like, you know, Miss Beth, can I do a Polish song? And I'm like, of course. You know, what's your favorite song? So I get the chance to learn too. And one person brought in this song about pierogies. It's like, it was like a little kid's song about pierogies. And everybody loved it. And we, you know, sang along with the pierogi song. And then, you know, next person doing their thing. What I want to also add is that presentation skills, even though that wasn't part of my job, really in the discussion class, they really came up. And it was something I was able to add to the class. And the students appreciated it. You know, once they were able to hear, like I said, hear themselves and how easier it is to understand when you're slower, more of them got involved with that or were able to do that. And the other thing was some of them got very involved and did and added props, okay, and got dressed up and used makeup and then had a friend. And then they were a little nervous about sharing that, that they were being too vulnerable or too exposed. One student particularly did something with the Taylor Swift song that he was just very, very creative with. And the class loved it. It gave him applause. I mean, he was like turning beet red in the classroom. But after it was over, it was like, you know, he was the star of that period for that time. So those are just some ideas I wanted to share. I wanted to give people some time if you want to ask any questions, if anybody has anything they want to ask. There's been some things going on here in the chat. But yeah, definitely the personalization part. And for me, it was so nice to be able to learn more about them this way and to be able to share, like I have a 20 plus students in 8 classes. So trying to get to know each student individually is difficult. I play games so that I can do that. I play a game where every student has to pick an adjective with their first name. Like for me, it's bold Beth, and then maybe attractive Agnes and silly Sue or whatever. And then we pass a ball around the room and we have to use that adjective with their name so that it helps me to learn who they are and also helps them learn who they are as well. But things like this just really help to bind the class. And I can walk down the hall and go, oh, there's Worth and Wind and Fire. You know, even though I don't know her name really at the moment, I can still remember that's Earth, Wind and Fire, you know, and it gives, it's just a tickle, you know, and it's fun. Let me see here. What is this? What are some issues which you should be careful with or take into consideration when making an order voyage country among the students? Yeah, like I said before, I always let the students know ahead of time, this is going to be shared. So if you don't want somebody to know something, don't write about it, don't draw about it, don't, you know, say anything. But if you do want me to know about it, let me know and I will, you know, understand it's just between you and I. And I've had students tell me this with things like mental health issues. This seems to be a huge issue now. And that was part of the reason I, you know, wanted to bring forward some of this stuff. And I think I said it in the little bio or whatever that came up with this webinar, is that COVID, I think, shut down a lot of students. And they were very honest with me about having anxiety and depression and were writing to me and saying, you know, I have anxiety and depression and I want to talk about mental health issues. And, you know, some other students had other things that were wrong and well, not wrong, but that they're like, you know, living with. And so they wanted me to know that. And so I piggybacked, like I said before, I piggybacked the timeline exercise with a mental health exercise that was part of the BBC. And they went over the article went over different health issues. And I've had different, like, what, how many discussion classes now? 7, 6, 7, 8 classes. And the students are always polite and say thank you and at the end. But in this particular lesson, I had 2 students hold back and just to stop and talk to me at the door and say, thank you so much for letting us talk about this today. And really took time to say thank you to me. So it was, I knew it was something big, you know, and they needed to do it. So I'm not as, and I am not a psychologist. I'm not like anything like that. I have experience, as all educators do, in classes that deal with mental health and wellness and things like that. And I don't, you know, say, I'm not there to be anybody's psychologist or psychiatrist or anything, but I want you to feel safe in this space to be who you are. And if that is part of who you are, I want you to feel safe to say that. And that's what happened. The feel that there's the level of safety with I'm okay how I am, you know, increased, which is, you know, that's what I want. That's what I want for them. Can you say if you have more than 50 students inside the class, your age is 14 to 17. Okay, so if you have more than 50, I mean, this timeline exercise still works with couple, with pairs. You can make them all do it and then they can still pair up and you can still rotate them. I've done this stuff with in big groups too. If you want to do the things with music, my suggestion is that you make it something like six people do per class. So if you have 40 or 50 kids, that you this six is going to go this week, this six is going to go this week, this six is going to go this week. And if they like the activity, it's going to be something that draws them to class, that they want to see what the next person's going to do, you know. So that can be helpful. Also, you know, things like that are on YouTube. I've used YouTube videos and articles in class for WH&H questions. That can stimulate too a lot of discussion. If you have 50 some students, most of them still are using, you know, if you allow cell phones in the class, I do, like I said, for older students, as long as it's used properly. And as soon as we're done with the activity, they go away or we put them aside or whatever. So with teenagers, they're so used to using this stuff now. I think it's a tool. I try not to make it the bad guy. I try to make the cell phone something we use and it's in the class and then we put it away. It's like anything else. Use it when it's useful. And then when you don't need it, put it away, you know, give it a place and time that's appropriate. And things like any articles that are online and all of that in order to save paper. This semester, I used very little to no paper this semester because I gave all of my assignments online and sent email links. Even the example for this, I put on a PDF and sent it to the students so we could be using less paper. So things that are online can help in that way too. And explaining that to the students as part of, you know, this is sustainability we're dealing with here too. You know, that's why we're gonna use our cell phones now. It's not because I'm a you know, easygoing teacher and I'm going to let you fool around with your cell phone. No, there is a purpose for it here. And it's to help us with this particular lesson. And then we're going to put it away. So, you know, just some ideas there for you. Anything else that I can help with anybody else? Thank you for showing up and coming out tonight. I don't know, like for some of the folks we've already said who are from different places, it's cold here in Poland, but I saw Brazil and I saw some of these other places that are pretty warm and it'd be nice to be warm. You can see what me, I have my scarf on and it's kind of cold here. I'm from Honolulu, actually, like I said, Hawaii. I did my training at School for International Training in Vermont. And I started overseas pretty soon after that. I've taught in Japan and South Korea, as well as Mexico and Spain and Poland. And I'm a licensed teacher in the US. I teach in Alaska, Hawaii, and California. And so I've been teaching English language learners from little ones, kindergartners, all the way up to people getting graduate degrees. So these are just some tricks of the trade that I've picked up along the way. I always have felt my peers are some of the best teachers. These things that I shared with you today, most of them were inspired by my colleagues And all of us like just seeing the reality of the classroom, looking at the talent in the room and trying to use those students' abilities to help them progress. Again, I would really encourage anyone to use drawing. Many people don't use drawing and they don't see it as a tool. But when you, if you came late, maybe you'll be able to see it later. The students' abilities are pretty amazing when it comes to drawing, besides music and them loving to share their interests with music. And that goes from all ages. I've taught third graders who wanted to share and get up and sing their favorite song, all the way up to university students who really find that as a way to connect to their peers. So yeah, I just want to encourage you with that. Any other questions for me? Anybody? You're welcome. Thanks for having me. I'm glad it's helpful. I hope it's helpful for others. Also being able to encourage students to do things like when they share their timelines and they see that this person has traveled to this country or this person's been someplace, trying to get the students to get excited about going abroad and doing other things. I know for our school here in Krakow, trying to get students excited to go and do Erasmus or something outside of just what's local is sometimes a challenge. Some of the students are kind of nervous about leaving and going abroad. But if they have peers that have done it and that can share that information, I have two of the students that I had here actually went abroad. And I think I missed sharing that with you. Let me try to find that one. One of my students, nope, not that one. Let me see. Here it is. She gave me this because she was going to Erasmus and she was going to miss out. So she wanted me to have her timeline and to be able to explain herself on the timeline. So other students, like you saw before, were actually drawing pictures and then figuring things out. She wrote it all up for me to explain it for me. And then I gave her a little bit of good luck over here in the corner, me and my crazy hair. Another way that you could use this, if you don't want to try to do a discussion with it, if you think that might be too much, they can do something like this as well, which is more like manga. A lot of students are very interested in Japanese manga and Japanese cartoons, all of that. I lived in Japan for 7 years, so I was able to share that with them. And I think that helped, get them excited about, okay, let's do some drawing, like my interest in manga or my interest with animation, anime. So I'll let you look at this. I think you can read this for yourself. She took a lot of effort in making sure she was correct. And so I didn't have too much to look at that was wrong. But then here she was in 2023 to go to York. This is where she is now as an Erasmus student. And so we were all really excited for her going on her voyage. So that's about it for me. Unless there's other questions, I want to make sure I give everyone the time. Kupuna. Kupuna. Oh. Thank you. So a big mahalo to everyone who showed up and was here with me tonight. Thank you for that. I hope this helps. Is there anything else that I can share? In case there's a problem with the certificate. Yeah. All right. Any more questions? Don't be shy.
We are post-COVID generation.
Yeah.
Irrespective of our age. Yes. Yeah. We are all in this.
Okay. So somebody's saying they still can't see the attached certificate link.
No link. The certificate itself has been attached. I'm attaching it for the third time. Yes. Right now. I have just attached it. Yes, and so everybody is able to download it directly from the chat box. So I have already attached it 3 times.
All right, great. Well, thank you so much. I really appreciate everybody showing up. I don't know when is the next event? When is the next webinar coming up?
The next webinar is coming up next week, and that is the webinar with Ula Kropaczewska. And Ula Kropaczewska is a specialist in the area of teaching young learners, the youngest learners. And next week she will tell us about games in English lessons. Yes, okay. So that is the next webinar on the 15th of February, as usual, 20:30 Central European time. So everybody is welcome to join us.
Okay. All right, great. And so you'll have your Valentine. That'll be like your Valentine, yeah?
Yes, you're right.
The Galentine or Palentine, whatever it is. This is something we've been discussing to my students. We're like, with the issue of Valentine's Day coming up, they're like, wait, it doesn't have to be Valentine's. It can be Galentine. It can be Palentine. It doesn't have to be just gal. So let me just double check and make sure. Okay, yeah, here was one other student's. I didn't get to share every timeline, but this was another student's version of their timeline going abroad. And again, like I said, for some folks showed up late and they didn't catch it all. Everybody's, had a different version with what they would draw. Some colored them in, some used blocks, some were stick figures. I didn't put any criteria on that. I just said, try to draw something that somebody would be able to identify. I am a stick figure person. So, as long as it was something people could identify, I gave them the credit for it. And for the most part, there wasn't any problem with that. The students were very good at making it clear. So, all right.
I would like to say one thing right now. Because, I'm really amazed by the way you are conducting this webinar. I didn't even have to present you at the beginning, yes? Oh. You said everything. You informed us about yourself and about your webinar. So you are like the whole orchestra.
Yes? Well, thank you for that. I wasn't quite sure how it was all going to go. This is my first webinar. So thank you, everybody. For making me feel welcome and fine doing this. It was kind of fun. Although I miss seeing people's faces, I'm seeing people's screens, but I'm not able to actually see eyes. And so it's kind of hard for me because I think you can tell I'm like really hands-on. So not seeing any, not being able to see people's faces, but.
Okay, let's do the following thing. Before we all leave the room, stop sharing the screen with us. And we will ask everybody to turn on their cameras and wave at you. Yes?
Oh, that would be lovely if you wouldn't mind.
Just stop sharing.
Okay, stop sharing.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. And now, yeah.
Oh, gracias por todo. Thank you, everybody. Mahalo.
It was amazing.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I hope it was helpful. Oh, my gosh.
Keep all waving. Right. I'm taking a screenshot and I will send it to Beth. Keep waving. Just don't stop. I'm waving too with my one hand. Okay. I will send you the screenshot. Great. Great. Right. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. All right. Good night, everybody. Good morning. Goodbye. Good afternoon, whatever your time zone. All right, mahalo. Aloha. Good luck. Happy New
Year. And
we
will keep in touch with Beth. I won't let her go.
Okay. All right. Bye.
Bye.